Frack on. Welcome to another episode of Frack The Canon, where I am joined by the coolest mother frackers around. I'm joined by Tyler. How are you doing, sir?
Doing well, how you doing?
Living the dream. And my brother from another mother, Mr. CJ McCree from Milwaukee. How you doing, sir?
I'm the co-host with the most, babe.
That's right. Co-host with the mostest. Alrighty. It's Halloween time, peoples. You know what time it is? Our favorite Halloween movies or something Halloween related. Tyler, this was your idea. Let's start with you, Mister. Present us with us the premise of this episode.
Oh man, you know what? It's funny. I forgot it was even my idea. So cool.
I remember.
Yeah. So the premise is a movie that could be Halloween related, that is super underrated, should be watched by everyone, is just an unknown entity that should be known.
Oh, Halloween related. Okay, then never mind. My film does not qualify for that, but
it could be. If you can on your own establish why it should be a Halloween movie, then it could be defined. But it could be any movie if that's where we're going.
Okay. Well, since it's your idea, Gustavo, let's start with you. What was yours?
So mine, a bit of backstory. My mom, this is one of her favorite movies, and around Halloween time every year we watch it together. It's a movie called Haunted Honeymoon.
It should have been the happiest moment of their lives, the night they came home to be married at the house of Great Aunt Kate. But it turned into a haunted honeymoon.
I know that one of you is a werewolf. Oh, oh, hairy, all over.
Someone or something is trying to scare them to death.
Now, if anything frightens you, anything at all, you just holler.
Holy baloney, here we go again.
I just found Cousin Francis in my bed.
Was he wearing a dress?
Yes, he was.
Just ask him to leave, sir. Tell him you have a headache.
Whatever happens,
who knows if any of us shall ever see the morning.
They have to be ready.
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I'm ready! 1, 2!
Spread your loving arms, clear out of space.
Beat it, while you're still healthy.
You do the eagle rock with style and grace.
Yes, sir! It's the biggest thrill of my life.
You put your left one out.
You'd think this would frighten me.
And bring it back.
It's not what do you think?
And that's what we come for in the jack.
Well, it's partly what you think, but wait. Oh, wait.
Starring Gene.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa.
Wilder.
Ah!
Gilda Radner.
Larry.
Oh, this thing's pinching my butt.
And Dom DeLuise in his most demanding role.
Oh, it's so complicated.
Haunted Honeymoon.
And it's by Gene Wilder, and he stars in it. And it's a whodunit sort of movie, kind of like Clue, with horror elements. And it's a type of movie Gene Wilder would be in. And it's a really funny movie. It's just a really poorly received by critics because Gene Wilder is doing his best Mel Brooks impression as a director. And a lot of people claim that this is sort of the end of his height of his comedic career, kind of declined from there. But I disagree. This is actually my favorite Gene Wilder movie. So if you are looking for a fun horror comedy movie, this is actually, in my opinion, one of the best ever made. So Haunted Honeymoon, that is my choice.
Question, is it Is it more horror inspired and just kind of more funny, or is it, are there actual like horror elements to it?
There's actual horror elements. There are scary parts. It's definitely more on the comedic end. It's from the angle of sort of young Frankenstein, because that also has scary moments, but it's the scarier movie than young Frankenstein. It's not like Blair Witch Project, you know, keep you up at night horror, but there's a few jump out of your seat moments.
Mm-hmm. Interesting, because Young Frankenstein is pretty like a straight faced parody kind of a thing, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's really like, yeah, it has like some horror elements to it, like.
Yeah, it's scarier than Young Frankenstein. There are some references to American Werewolf in, or an American, what is that movie called? American Werewolf in Paris or American Werewolf in London.
London.
Yeah. Yeah, it came out after that. And both of them, yeah, they came out after whichever one came out first. And there's some homage to that movie as well in it.
Nice.
All right, CG, what's yours, good sir?
All right, mine is if anybody who watches this show has even heard of this movie, I kudos to you, okay? because we were talking a little bit before we started recording, but I can't remember who in our friends group was the first person to put me on to this movie, but it's a romp. Let me just tell you what the kind of freaking genre this is, and you'll know immediately if it's something that you want to check out. This is an action comedy horror sci-fi samurai zombie reincarnation flick. All right, if any of those freaking are hot buttons to you that make you sound interested in it, it's rad. You should definitely check it out. Like I'm just gonna read this the synopsis on IMDb.
Well, what is it called?
Versus. It's called Versus.
なんなんだあの化け物どもはや。お前らの遊び相手だろ。ここは薄気味悪くて好きじゃねえ。この森おかしい。結界。この世とあの世を繋ぐゲートだ。死人が化け物になって生き返るって言うんだろ。あいつら確かに死んでたのに生き返ってきたよな。
俺はな、人に指図されるのが嫌いなんだよ。筋はいいんだけど。
Like, is it spelled out the full word or just VS?
It spells out the full word. So it's called, there are 666 portals that connect this world to the other side. These are concealed from all human beings. Somewhere in Japan exists the 444th portal, the Forest of Resurrection, right? So when the movie starts, it's like, oh, and I forgot gangster too, to add to all those other tags that I put in there. I forgot gangster. So the movie starts, And it's like these Yakuza are trying to like basically like they're like doing a hit on these people, and they're bringing them off into the forest to, you know, kill them, dump the bodies and what have you. And they do that, and those bodies get resurrected because they're in the forest of resurrection. You know what I mean? You know, so like there's this kind of becomes like the first like act of this movie is a zombie flick. Because like they're in this forest of resurrection and all these dead bodies that are like just rising and like, you know what I mean, attacking them. But it just gets deeper in that. It turns out like the guy who's like I won't give everything away from the movie, just like give a little more of the plot or whatever, just so you can kind of make a more decision. But it turns out like the guy who is the person who is responsible for this happening, who's chasing our main character, because our main character like doesn't even have a name. He's just like this random, like either prisoner or thug. It's been a long time since I've seen it, but the guy is after him. He can't really figure out why, but it turns out like it has all to do with like reincarnation, and these two entities have been battling for like hundreds of years, like at each other. It's like it becomes this crazy thing, and it's such a wild movie. But yeah, if you like freaking horror, like it's like six genres, you know what I mean? It's like a horror action comedy movie, you know what I mean, like with samurai elements and yakuza elements and sci-fi elements. And if any of that sounds interesting, I'd say, hey, you know what I mean, waste an afternoon on it. It's a wild ride.
That sounds really funny. It sounds interesting. I'll probably check it out. Sounds a little bit like Battle Royale a little bit, but maybe over the era.
Yeah, it's actually around that same era. And it's totally a low budget movie. Like if you get like, if you end up picking it up and getting like the Steelbook, like special edition, like they'll go into all of the stuff. Like they'll go into all, it was super interesting. Back, me and René were in film school, take a shot. But it came out right then. So it was right around the time when it was like super interesting to like look at all the elements they used to make this film. In fact, a little tidbit, the main character, the actor who plays the main character broke his tooth, because there's like this scene where he cocks his gun with his teeth, and like it does look cool, but like he like broke his tooth on doing that or whatever, and they had to like repair it. But yeah, it's crazy. It's a cool movie.
That's pretty cool. That sounds awesome. I might check that out. Tyler, what are your thoughts on CJ's pick? And CJ, what are your thoughts on Tyler's pick?
His pick, what did I say? What movie was that again? Haunted Honeymoon. That might be something that I might check out eventually. Like, I like little cool, like, horror. One of the things I like about horror comedies is that they usually don't drop the horror aspect of them. They, like, keep the horror in them, unless they're, like, a straight parody, like, Scary Movie or something. But they usually keep horror elements in it, and I like that sort of, like, it's kind of like a sweet and salty mix, right? Like, that sort of, like elements, like, here's some comedy, here's some horrifying things, and I think they pair well together.
Yeah, I thanks, CJ. And for your pick, I was watching the trailer without sound while you were talking. And it's the kind of movie I like to see. One of my favorite movies of all time is Kung Fu Hustle.
That's such a good movie.
Yeah, and I kind of get a little bit of that, like, Stephen Chow vibes from the trailer I was seeing. So I like what I see. I'm definitely going to be watching it.
Nice.
My movie, you know what I realized? I've never finished watching this movie. I always watch it to like the third act or a little bit to the end, but I never watching it. But I don't know how to finish this. But it is called Studio 666. And it is a Foo Fighters movie.
Foo Fighters, you gotta get me a record.
It's our 10th album. We gotta break the mold on this one.
Let's go. Let's go somewhere we've never been.
This place is amazing.
Do you guys get this overwhelming sense of debt? Doesn't really seem like the right fit.
Whoa, that's rad.
That was weird. The sound of this house is the sound of album 10.
All right, aren't you guys amps? Living room.
Let me apologize in advance for all the rock we're about to make.
Got a couple of ideas I've been working on. I'll lay them on you.
Dude, wait.
It's called Everlong, and you wrote it about 20 years ago.
How you feeling?
Everything okay?
Ever since we moved into this house, my mind is flooded.
We all have writer's block.
This is not just a creepy rock and roll house. It allows spiritual entities to cross into our world.
Oh my God!
Dude has got one flew over the cuckoo's nest crazy.
It's this place, man.
Let's finish the track.
Can't we just wait, dude?
Just play the drums.
Found a new musical note?
Hell yes, I did.
It's an L.
Any chefs in the group?
I'm pretty handy on the grill.
Yeah, you like your meat charred and dry.
He does make a killer barbecue.
That's it! What do?
We go save his ass.
Is the album almost done?
Yeah, it's killer.
Here you go, man. Finish the song.
You did.
It is pretty much a Dave Grohl and the band need to turn in a 10th album. Because that's the part. I get to this part, and for some reason something happens. Is that Steve Grohl? Who is that? Dave Grohl and the regular Foo Fighters need to turn in an album. And they find his apartment. There's this house somewhere up in L.A., but you find out that there's some murder, some weird stuff has been going on in that apartment. Like, there's been murder, people have died. And one night, just Dave Grohl can't sleep or whatever. Just like, he's just got writer's block. And he's like, to the point where he starts singing Hello from Lionel Richie.
Dreams, I've kissed your lips a thousand times. I sometimes see you pass outside my door. Hello.
Hello, Dave.
Lionel!
We all have writer's block, you know? But that's my song.
That's my song. You understand what I'm saying? I like that song. No. I love that song. That's one of my favorite songs. I love singing that song. Love that song. Get your own song, nerd.
Like, Dave Grohl goes off in this thing. Somehow he falls in down this attic or whatever, and he finds this weird, there's a raccoon, like, crucified, and it opened up, and he's just like, these weird demon shadow demons are coming out of him, at him. And he gets possessed or whatever, and then he goes back up. And then little by little, like, the other members of the fire start bugging him or pissing him off as he's trying to write the song. Like this, while he's playing, he finds this awesome song, he discovers this note called the L note or whatever. And so they play it for like half an hour to an hour. And like, our song's almost done. And like, we're going to release an hour-long song. And so the others keep pissing him off, and he kills the members. He burns the guitarist Chris at the grill. When Tyler Hawkins, R.I.P. Tyler Hawkins, like, does it with his drum, with his drum set, like, he throws his cymbal at him, and it, like, breaks it, like, this two halves of his head. It's, I'm like, I can't do horror, as you guys know. I get scared very easily. I'm a little punk when it comes to scary movies. So I'm like, I can handle this, because it's funny. It's ridiculous. CJ, you know this. Tyler, I think you do, too. The Exorcist, like, what else? Freddy versus Jason. Like, I can't do that. This I can handle.
And so, yeah, like, so you can handle gore, but the jump out scares.
Because really. The thing, dude, I don't like gore either, but it is so cartoonish, this gore, that you're like, dude, I can't. I can deal with this. Mm-hmm. This is fine. This is cool runnings, as I was saying. I think it's, but like I said, I have yet to finish watching it. I started it three times and I never get to it, but I'm like, all right, I gotta finish eventually. But from what I've seen so far, it's awesome. And Dave Grohl should have won an Oscar.
What did they release this on?
Huh?
What did that release on?
It was in theaters.
It had a theater release. It had a limited theater release. But, like, I bought the Blu-ray because I got to keep physical media alive. Frack you, Best Buy.
Yeah.
We can talk about that later offline. But it came out last year. It came out last year or 2021. And it came out physical copy I think it came out last year. Or not last year. I think it came out 2021 for Halloween season. And they came out like physical, digital, early 2022.
Yeah.
Called Studio 666. And there's not Jim Garland. There's some other people like cameos. Oh, my favorite one is the Lionel Richie cameo. My God, my own damn song.
That sounds awesome. When you were talking about the plot, what it reminds me of is, like, you remember that Family Guy episode where, like, randomly, like, in the background, like, you see, like, the advertisements for, like, Kiss Saves Christmas or whatever, like, yeah. Like, it's just, like, yeah. The plot, like, the generic plot of, like, a blank in Christmas, like, sort of, like, famous thing in Christmas that they have in there, like, that just reminds me of that, like, oh, this is the Halloween band movie, you know?
Exactly, and it's so awesome, because when's the last time we saw, one of these kind of, like, a band movie. I know Kiss, there was a Kiss movie in the 70s, but there was a Metallica concert, like,
yeah,
10 years ago, Metallica, but it was a concert film. This is a straight up, like, a narrative movie. So, I mean, this is kind of, this is fun. This is Halloween.
It's been a minute.
Mm-hmm.
I looked up the cast. Jenna Ortega's in it.
Yes, she is.
Yeah.
Like, for like a minute or two.
Yeah. Whitney Cummings.
That's her name. Whitney Cummings, James Garland, I believe.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's pretty funny because of the horror aspect, but then the killing scenes is in the vein of Freddy Krueger or like Jason. What is funny how people, the way people die.
Yeah.
I like it a lot.
Yeah, it's a hard sell to say this is like potentially the most underrated Halloween movie ever.
Yeah, that's mine. Is there anything else you guys want to touch on?
Any honorable mentions, I guess, anybody got? I can rattle off one.
Go ahead.
The only other one that's, like, kind of underrated, but it did get kind of a cult following, though, for a minute, but Tucker and Dale versus Evil.
That was a good one.
You guys heard of that one or seen that one?
I have heard of that one. I know it's that with, for two Alan. Reasons. The Red Speed Rangers in that movie. And Carly told me about it. So I'm like...
Alan Tudyk, and I forget who the other lead actor is, but it's just... It's kind of like the straight-faced, like, parody kind of movie where it basically, like, takes the premise of, like the Texas Chainsaw Massacre and flips it on its head. So you have Tucker and Dale, who are like really just if this is an offensive term, I'm sorry, but like just a couple of hicks, and they like really like, but they're like good dudes and they really just want to help, and like a couple of, like this car full of teens, you know, like the classic, like pulls into town and gets like lost in the small town or whatever. This car full of teens pulls up and like their car breaks down, and so Tucker and Dale are mechanics and they want to help this car full of teens, but the teens are so scared of Tucker and Dale because they think they're like some serial killers that they basically end up like all over the course of this movie all killing themselves just trying to get away from Tucker and Dale. Like, so it's just like this really funny problem because it's like it's basically like told from the point of view of the serial killer, but they're not serial killers. Like, they just keep accidentally killing these kids, or they end up killing themselves, like, in these gruesome and horrible ways. But yeah,
For me, the scary movie franchise, or it's just completely parodies scary movies. That came out around Halloween time, and I'll say this too about just that. Like franchise, that's in my opinion like the best like parody of a genre type movie. I know they're super campy, those scary movies, but it's one of those movies where like no matter what, you're having a good time. And I mentioned underrated because people forgot those existed. they're still widely understood, but still good at shout out.
The first two are really funny, and then the Wayne siblings left, and it took a really, really, really big dip in quality.
Yeah,
I forgot about. So I'm like, one and two. I'll give you yes. One and two are awesome, but I remember I went to go see the third one. I'm like, this is a piece of poop.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think. I don't know if it's a Halloween movie. I don't know if it's. I can't think. Because it's so well done. It's such a good movie. It got actually no, it's not. At least Shaun of the Dead, but that's not overrated. That's overrated almost. Because it's so popular. It's
appropriately rated.
It's yeah, I was going to say it's rated.
I can't. It's hard for me because I don't do horror that often. All right, you know what? I'll say this one because it's still kind of scary for me. This is one scene. Signs.
Signs. The one that the alien.
Yes, with Brazil. That scene. Yes. I remember screaming. I'm like, ah.
Yeah, dude, that's one of the scariest moments because it's so because the movie's pretty boring. The whole movie, you're like, when's something gonna happen? And then it's like almost the end, and it's like because it looks so real. Yeah, I love Signs just because that one scene.
Yeah, it's great. Signs is great.
Kudos for shouting that out.
Well, I think that is his last good movie.
Yeah. He got really weird after that one.
Yeah, you might be right about that.
And I think after that is either The Village or Lady in the Water.
Yeah. Lady in the Water and Village. Or Village and then Lady in the Water, I think, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Shyamalan.
And then everything else went. Everything else, I haven't seen any. I think the last M. Night Shyamalan movies I saw.
I saw Devil and it didn't suck.
I see Devil, but there was.
Get it through old.
I didn't watch them.
It was so weird.
So Mr. Glass and the one Glass or the and the one with Professor X.
Yeah.
Split.
Some people split.
Yeah.
Then they made that like an Avengers thing where the three
with
of
Glass.
Them.
Yeah.
Yeah. I thought that was kind of cool, but I'm like, you're too late, dude. You should have done this like 10 years earlier, like when you were still ahead.
After Signs.
I love dude, but I think Signs.
Bruce Willis was still a somebody.
Oh,
I was gonna make a joke.
Sorry. Yeah, I forgot about his. I forgot he's going through some stuff.
You want me to cut it out?
Sorry, B Dubs. Sorry, B Dubs.
Do you want me to keep it out or do you want to keep it in?
I don't care. Whatever. Let him roast me, or take it out. It's your show. You know.
it's our show.
He's admitting his mistake here. It's fine.
Yeah.
All right. You did. I forgot to say, but it was. I got nothing. Like, that was the one. Final comments, final thoughts.
Halloween movies aren't really a thing anymore.
They aren't. They were all the places in the 90s. I remember that. Like every year there was a good. Like the last time I remember, I think it was This is Halloween. It was not even. Hocus Pocus was the last thing I can remember being a Halloween movie. But that came out in the summer.
93. Yeah. And about Hocus Pocus 2 came out last year and it was pretty terrible because it was straight to streaming. And Disney has already announced they're going to make a Hocus Pocus 3. And it's just like, stop, please.
I hope it's better than 2. I just remember being very, very underwhelmed by 2.
Yeah, me too. And it was in that time during COVID when we're all desperate for
content. Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's my fault.
Then what's that? Saw took over Halloween for a while too, because they were like that's how we got so high on Saw movies because they were trying to come out with them every year.
Because is this Saw 10 that just came out?
That's coming out right now. Yeah,
oh,
just came out.
Well, that's weird. They did it in 10 years, where Jason took it. 20 years to get to Jason X?
Yeah. But, you know, obviously it was a priority for Saw to come out every year, though.
Yeah.
Like, they were making that a priority for themselves, so.
They were the Call of Duty of movies.
You're right.
Jason in space.
Yeah, why do that?
Because it was 2000. I got nothing else. I'm just tired. I like it. I'm gonna check it out. I'm gonna check out Versus. I'm gonna check out Haunted Honeymoon. I got nothing else. Any final comment, final thoughts for you guys? I know we got CJ's. Tyler.
Oh, you flipped it. I had mine.
Oh,
CJ,
sorry.
Final thought, yeah.
CJ.
Oh, nothing. No, just, you know, happy Halloween, everybody, and all that, you know. I like a good Halloween movie here and there. So, yeah.
All righty. Thank you guys for joining me. We'll see you same bracket time, same bracket channel. Boo. Hey, boo-boo.
Bigger look a basket?